Okay, chapter 22. AC and domestic electricity. Okay, here we have four sessions. First session, 22.1, mains electricity. What is the mains electricity? Electricity 电力 mains 总电力。Okay, 俗语即系话我哋嘅湿电。Okay, 用的電。Okay, now look at this. From the wall socket, 插頭同埋插座 socket 插座插頭係 plug, P L U G. Okay, look at this. When we have a name, this one, and then we put the plug inside the socket, then we will have the complete circuit to provide energy for the light bulb.So here, the name obtains energy, not current. Okay, even we have the current, but without any energy, this is useless. Now look at this. Here, you should know that we have two types of currents. One is the DC, the other one is the alternating current. DC, means that the direct current. Direct means that one direction only.Okay, what's the meaning of one direction only? It means that in mathematics, if at any time the current is positive, maybe from left to right, no change in direction, then we can say that may be positive. Even we have the variation. Never mind. Okay, so if like that, we can say that this one is DC, only one direction. It can be steady, can be variating.Okay, so for example, if you draw this diagram like that, no problem. This one is also DC. Even you can see that the current should be negative way, no problem. But how about the other one? The other one is alternating current AC, 交流电。头先嗰只叫做直流电。So what will happen? The current direction will be changed from time to time. Then you can see that the current may fall in anti-clockwise direction or maybe fall in clockwise direction. If I say that clockwise direction is positive, then anti-clockwise direction will be negative. In this case, you can see that the direction of the current will be changed. This one go up, this one go down. Then in this case, we will say thatAlternating current, 交流电it means that the current is changing the direction. In wave, you should know that this one is the one cycle. One cycle, the time for one cycle, we will say that one period T. And in each cycle, we will have two directions for the current. Maybe for half cycle, the current may be positive, maybe anticlockwise.Then the other cycle will be negative, will be clockwise direction. Okay, then this current, this type of the current, we will say that alternating current, AC. And how about the circuit symbol? If this one is DC, exactly the same as battery. Okay, longer one is positive, shorter one will be negative. Then it means that the battery will be DC.The current should be flow from positive to negative, only one direction. But how about for AC? The symbol will be like that, exactly similar to the sine function. This one means that the current may be flowing this way, next time may be flowing this way. When you look at this power supply in the laboratory, you can see that here AC, it means that the output will be AC. The current may be coming out from here,or come in, okay, depends on the cycle. And for DC, this one, positive, it means that the current must come out here and then come in to the negative terminal. Section B, mains voltage in Hong Kong. This one tells us that in Hong Kong, using the main supply, the main electricity, the voltage supply should be this. 220 watts, 220 watts in AC, It means that for the mains, the current should be alternating. It means that from one way maybe come out and then the other way maybe come in. And also we have the frequency. It means that in one second, here we will have the 50 cycles for it. Now look at that, this simple diagram for it. This one is the mains, from the generator, 发电厂, okay? And here, what will happen? You can see the color of them. For the earth wire, daisin, okay? Daisin. Here, you can see the green and yellow, okay, like that. Then this one is the earth wire. Pay attention, this one is the socket. The socket, the upper one will be the earth wire. And for the right-hand side, this one is the live wire. And the other one is the neutral wire. Okay, in this one, it means that the mains, inside the mains, we have these three types of the wire. And also, we have three different names for it. Okay? But what is the function of them? Look at this. For the earth wire, earth, it means that this wire should be connected to the ground. Okay? And how about the neutral? Neutral means that nothing. Usually, we will say that this one should be 0 volt. The potential should be 0. Then, this one should be connected to the ground. And also, in some way, it will go back to the generator. But keep it 0 volt. At normal case, okay? But how about the live wire? Everything is 0, so live wire should be greater than 0, otherwise it cannot provide AC in this voltage, okay? So a live wire tells that the potential should be variating. Next line should be like that. For the live wire, potential changing between positive V0. V0, this one is the peak value. 波峰波谷的 value, okay? Peak value. V0 or negative V0. But neutral wire will keep it always 0 watt. Okay, when you look at this circuit, you can see that, for example, here will be the live wire. Then at the time, maybe positive V0, but neutral wire must be 0 watt. But for next half cycle, this one may be negative peak voltage, and this one also keep it 0 watt. Once again, the frequency is 50 Hz. It means that in one cycle, the time for it should be 0.02 seconds. It means that the period, okay, it will change the direction. When I draw the diagram for the VT graph, pay attention, this V means that the voltage should be like that. In the first half cycle, should be positive. Next half cycle will be negative. How about the total time? Here should be 0.02 seconds. Once again, go back to this value. But what is the meaning of 220 watts AC? This one just needs the average value. Okay, average one. It means that the peak value of it should not be 220. The average one should be 220. But how about the peak value? Should be 311. In the later part, you will see that you will know that this how to find out this peak value should be related to square root 2. Okay, square root 2, 220. The answer will be 311. Okay, but how to do it? In the later session, you will know it. Okay? So, once again, tell you again, 220 just only the average value. Okay? In each time, in each second, the voltage of the live wire is changing. Sometime maybe 0, sometime maybe peak value, positive 311, or sometime maybe positive 220. Sometimes it's 0, and the other time may be negative 311, negative 220, and also 0. Okay? Okay, so this one, the potential on the live wire or in the live wire should be changing with time. Part C, power rating. Because in our daily life, we will use the means. Okay, the means. What is the function of it? You should connect appliance on it. 家庭電器, okay? And on the mains, then the appliance will be functioned normally, will be operating. So like this, power when operating normally, 正常運作,插了濕電,正常運作. Then what will happen? When you look at the appliance, you can see this label. This label tells us that if this appliance can be operated at this voltage, 220 watts AC, then this appliance can produce or can consume this power. Okay, so look at this. The rated voltage, it means that the operating voltage should be 220 in AC. Then the power consumed will be 1000 watts. If you have this label, this one, we will say that power rating. Okay, this one is further explanation. If applied voltage is lower than the rated value, it means that it's not operating voltage, then this appliance cannot be operated normally. Cannot be operated normally, it means that the power consumed cannot be 1000 watts, should be lower than 1000 watts. But how about this? It's greater than the rated value. Okay, then here will be overheat because the power consumed will be greater than 1000 watts, maybe 4000 watts, then this one must be overheat. Okay, now try to look at the first example. One. Okay, look at this. A power of a steam iron. 燙斗, okay, 蒸氣燙斗. In this, usually in examination, especially in short level, it will give you the photo of the appliance and also give you this label. You should notice that in this label, you can get some important value. The value in it should be the power rating. Try to find out the voltage, try to find out the power. Now, look at this. During normal operation, it means that under normal case, it means that fulfill this label, the reading in the labels. What is its power? Very easy. You just need to look at the label and then find out the power. This power will be the normal case, 1000 watts. Okay? Part B, what is the current? Try to use the last equation, you should know it, in power. Power, go back to here. We know that the power, 1000. How about the other thing that we can read in from the label? Should be the voltage. We have the power, we have the voltage. We want to find out I, current. Should be P is equal to IV. Using this one, then we can get it, this current. This current will be the operating current. Okay, we provide 220 watts AC and operate at this current 4.558. Then this appliance can operate normally and the power consumed will be 1000 watts. Part C, what is its resistance? Similarly, we have the voltage, we have the power. We can use this formula and then find out the resistance in it. Okay. What if question? In Colombia, the main supply is different from Hong Kong. Hong Kong is 220, but in Colombia, maybe 110. Then, if the iron is operated there, it means that we use the same iron, but use it in Colombia. Then what will happen? What is its power? Once again, look at this. Because the voltage is not the same, it means that it cannot operate at normal voltage. The normal voltage should be 220, but now only 110. Then what will happen in this? What is its power during normal operation? Here, the assumption is very, very important. The resistance should not be should not have any change. Okay, because we use the same iron. Now look at this. Because the power should not be the same, but all should be the same. The operating voltage now in here should not be the same, only 110. Then after the calculation, you can find out the power consumed should be 250 watts, only a quarter of the normal case. Okay? 所以有个烫斗呢，平时可能一分钟就好热噶啦，而家可能四分钟先咁热嘅，炸咗。Okay, next. This one is the case when we connect different light bulb in different way, then what will happen? Okay, like this. Operating power depends on the actual voltage applied. Even we connect these two light bulb to the mains, 220 watts, but because they are connected in series, then it means that they should share the total voltage provided by the mains. It means that they cannot get 220 watts because they are connected in series. 得唔得？佢哋应该分担220，但系而家一齐分担，所以冇人可以攞到220。So it means that even this neighbor show us that this neighbor power rating 220 watts, then the power should be 100 watts.But this one is enabled. If you give it the voltage 220, then it can operate this. But now you can see that they are share. They share the voltage. It means that they cannot reach 220, should be less than 220. Then what should you do? The same. Here, very important concept. Give your power rating. It means that you can get V from this reading. You can get power.From this reading, use P and V, we can get I because P is IV. And also, we can use P is equal to V square over R, we can get R. Okay, actually, give you power rating, this true value, you can get everything. Okay, now, which one should not be changed? Okay.What is it? Should be R. So, in this part, the main focus point should be R. But how to get R? This one. Normal operating case situation. Power should be 100 and the voltage should be 220. Then you can get this R. Next time, different V will have different power, but V will have the same R.So you should calculate the R. Okay? From the calculation, you can find that RA and RB should be these two. Okay? And using division of voltage, 分擔電阻越大分得越多，電阻越細分得越少 in ratio. So using the ratio, you can find that the PD across light bulb B is this, PD across light bulb A is this.This one tells us that both of them are not, okay, 220. It means that both of them cannot operate normally. 正常發光100火，但係而家得82瓦同1300瓦，一定低過220瓦，所以出嚟嘅光度一定暗咗。Okay, but how much calculate? Only these two. Okay, then, what is the final conclusion?You can see that A is higher power rating, but why? Series circuit, they have the same I, no change, but we want to get power. We should use I square R, but because they are connected in series, common current, so power should be depends on resistance. Greater resistance, greater power. So you can see that.Greater resistance, greater power. Okay? Now, try to look at try to watch the other movie. This one.
This one has 2 different 壓定功率的燈泡，分別是40瓦特和100瓦特。 如果将它们以并联的方式连接至市电电源，然后闭合电路，我们可以发现100瓦特的灯泡是光一点的。假如将它们以串联的方式连接至市电电源，然后闭合电路，咦，今次100瓦特的灯泡暗了很多，同学知不知道为什么呢？
OK，
闭合电路。
OK， in this movie, you can see that this one. In this video clip, you can see this one. If we connect this two light bulb in parallel, once again in parallel circuit, you should know that the special point for the parallel circuit and parallel circuit, what is it? Should be the common voltage. OK, both of them will have 220 watts. Okay, so it means that they will operate in 220 watts, but they will have this power. It means that both of them can operate normally. Okay, then what will happen? Normally means that, look at this, if in the power rating show it 40 watts, it means that in operating voltage 220, the power should be 40, but the other one should be 100. 100 watts should be brighter than the 40. Then you can get it. 100 watt light bulb will be brighter than this because the power consumed should be higher in parallel circuit. But how about next in series circuit?
今次一百
In series circuit, you can see that will be the last example. Common current depends on the resistance. Okay, a greater power, it means that the resistance should be less than the other one. So it means that 40 watts should be greater resistance. Greater resistance, but same current. Then it means that the power of it should be greater than next one. But once again, you can see that 40 watt light bulb should be brighter than 100 watt light bulb. But pay attention. Even this one is brighter than this, but its power is not 40, should be lower than 40. Okay, we can use the calculator to do it. It means that the last example, you can see that this one is not the actual power, should be less than original power. Okay, pay attention on the calculation. Look at this, a heating device of usually of a higher power, 高電能的儀器通常是發熱發得多的。 OK, for example, for the fan, only this, but for the kettle, 電水煲2000, 燙斗1000, like that. OK, chapter 1, true false question. The potential of the live wire varies with time. Of course, yes. From positive 311 to 0 and then to negative 311. In each cycle. For each for one cycle, the period of it should be 1 over 50. It means that 0.02 seconds. Part B, current always flows from live wire to neutral wire. Wrong. Because AC should be changed periodically. Sometime from live to neutral, the other time may be from neutral to live. Part C, potential of the live wire is always positive. No, can be positive, can be zero, can be negative. Part D, equation for this, V is IR, P is IV, are valid for DC only. Because in last topic, everything should be related to battery. Battery is DC. And in this question, tell us that true for DC, but how about for AC? No, these two equations are valid for both AC and DC. We will prove it later. Question number two. That's name, the 台灯, is connected to the mains, 220 watts, and frequency given to you. Why does the name not flicking? 不会闪呢？点解唔会？佢唔系话唔会闪，点解唔会 唔会闪到我哋 notice 到，即系我哋感觉到佢闪咧。Because this one, brightness of the light bulb varies at 50 Hz, too fast for us to notice it. Once again, for a human being, we can see the frame per second. For a human being, only 20 to 25, then we will feel that this moving picture, changing picture, is a smooth movie. 因为我哋脑里面有视觉残留，菲林每秒钟转20个菲林或者25个菲林，我哋已经觉得那些不是静止的菲林，是在动着的动画，或者会是一个在动着的 video， 我们不觉得它闪亮的，或者是窄下窄下的。 Part B， What is the equivalent steady DC voltage that gives the same brightness？It means that this one should be equivalent to the average value, should be 220. Okay. Once again, this one tells us that 220 is the average value. For the peak one, should be 311. Question number 3. Compute the following table if the appliance show the following rating. For the keto, this one, P, watt, it means that the power should be 2000. Voltage is 110. You can use P is IV to do this calculation. For R, you should use P V square over R. Then you can do the calculation this. For part B, toaster, also a heating device. Now this one gives you current, gives you resistance, and then calculate back power and voltage.Alex, Waybox， Waybox 即係嗰啲學校做嗰個燈箱啊。This， OK， 沃夫嘅嗰個板啦嚇，熱板。This， Torch， 手提電筒。This， OK， Question number 4。In the previous question， if we connect the toaster。And the wolf iron in series, pay attention, this one in series. Okay, in series to 220 main supply. It means that both of them cannot operate at 220 because division of voltage. So what will happen? What is the current draw from the main supply? Once again, if the question gives you like this, you should calculate.The resistance first, because this one will not be changed. If we can get this resistance, we also have the main voltage, then we can get the main current. This. Okay? Question number 5. Here, we have two sets of light bulbs, set 1 and set B, whose weight value are so. It means that this one should be the power weighting. IfThis one operate in this voltage, 12 watts, then the power consumed should be this. Then look at this. For each set, which bulb is the brightest? Connected in series. Connected in series means that this one, light bulb A, light bulb B, and light bulb C. Once again, you should remember the characteristics of the circuit connected in series should be common current.For the brightest, should be depends on I square R. Because I should be the common current, it means that power should be related to R. Okay, so what should you do? Try to find out all resistance and then compare it. But how to find out? By using the power rating in order to find out the R. R should be what? P is V square over R. But now R and P exchange the position, should be this.Okay, try to notice that this one. If the operating voltage is 12 watts, then it gives this power. You can see that all the operating voltage of this should be the same. Then it means that depends on the power. This one, greater value, greater power, then it means that R should be less. Then you can see that this one, all should be the minimum. This all should be maximum. And then once again, in silver circuit should be this. Greater auto, greater power. That's all. Okay, so look at this. P is equal to I squared R. Largest R will be the brightest one. Okay? Here, V, weighted value, or P, weighted value. It means that R should be largest one. Okay? Then A and Z will be the brightest one. Okay? You understand? Part B. Connected in parallel. Connected in parallel, then what will happen? This light bulb, light bulb, and light bulb. Once again, remember that for parallel circuits should be common V, common voltage. Look at this. For set 1, the common voltage should be the same, 12 volts. Then which one should be the brightest one? Because all of them can operate in this operating voltage, 12 volts. Then it means that the power consumed should be the value shown in the label. Okay, so light bulb C should be the brightest one. How about this? In this, because they are not operating in the same voltage, but they will have the same power, then what will happen? The same. Try to find out the resistance. P is V square over R. Find out resistance first, R, and this one is P. All of them, power should be the same, but different V. Greater V, greater R. But in parallel circuit, if R is greater, then what will happen? Because power should be related to V squared over R. But in parallel circuit, V should be common one. No change at all. Greater R, power will be lesser. Okay, so go back to here, try to find it out. Same power, because all of them should be 10. Same power, okay, but higher in voltage. For example, is that 36, then resistance will be maximum. If this one is maximum, it means that the power should be the less. Okay, so this one, X will be the brightest one. Okay, last session in this, part D, kilowatt hour. Okay, kilowatt hour, what is the meaning? It means that we know that in order to provide light from the light bulb, you should provide energy. This type of energy should be the electrical energy. But how to measure it? Of course, we know that we should use the joule to measure it. But joule actually is a very small value. And when we operate a light bulb maybe for 10 hours or for a month, then actually we consume a large amount of energy. Now the scientist wants to reduce it, to change it into different value, to make it smaller in value. Okay, so here introduce kilowatt hour. And pay attention, try to remember the definition of kilowatt hour. What is it? Should be the amount of energy supply to the appliance, but this appliance will be operate in 1000 watts in 1 hour. 1个钟头，佢运作正常运作1000伏，咁需要嘅能量几多咧？就会叫做1个 kilowatt hour. So you can look at this conversion. 1 kilowatt, kilo means that 1000. 1 hour we have 3600 seconds. Multiply that of them, then we can get this one. It means that 1 kilowatt hour is a new unit. This one equivalent to this 3 to 6 million joule. Million joule is very many zero. So like this, because we want to use the kilowatt hour, in Chinese will be 一度 binding unit, building unit. Okay. Building unit, this one, 一度电. Okay, we want to simplify it using this unit. Okay, But how to measure the kilowatt hour? We will use a kilowatt meter or a joule meter. You can look at this. So it kilowatt hour meter. If you can see that this one 7, next one will be 8. From 7 to 8, it means that it will consume 1 kilowatt hour. It means that 3.6 million joule. This one exactly the same. 屋企裏面個電錶呢都係咁樣嘅。因為都係咁樣計電噶，轉咗一度，即係用咗一度電。Example two, save energy, save money. It means that in this question, in this example, you can calculate the total energy we consume, and then you should know that how much you should pay for it. Okay, look at this part A. There are 500 watts. Okay, ceiling light bulb. In this one and every night operate 5 hours, and the cost for 1 kilowatt hour should be $0.9. Estimate the monthly cost 30 days. Then try to find out, we have 5 light bulb here, 5 light bulb, but here each light bulb the power consumed should be only 0.1 kilowatt. Pay attention, you should convert 100 watts into 0.1 kilowatts. Then you can see that this one, we have 5 light bulb, each one, here, we have 5 light bulb, each one will be 100 watts, but change it, kilowatts. And here, each day, we will operate them 5 hours. 1 month, we have this one. It means that we have totally 150 hours for whole the process. And what is a kilowatt hour? Kilowatt hour. You just need to calculate this part and this part, multiply them together. You can get this. It means that we will use 75 kilowatt hour. For each one, $0.9. After calculation, this one will be the cost per month. Part B here. We have the other type of the light bulb, okay, 光管, compact fluorescent bulb. The power should be less than last one, 100 watts, 慳電膽, okay, compared with this. Then here what will happen, we replace all of them with this. How much can we save per month? Of course, you should calculate the total cost for it, similar to the last one. Power is reduced to 1/5. Energy consumed should be 1/5. The cost should be 1/5. 所以啦，換曬慳電膽會慳錢又慳能量。OK， 咁就計咗數，計咗出嚟啦。OK， checkpoint two. Before checkpoint two, try to look at this one.
In this experiment, we'll use a kilowatt hour meter to measure the electrical energy supplied to an electric kettle. First, connect the kettle to the kilowatt hour meter. Then, pour some water into the kettle.Check the calibration of the kilowatt hour meter. Calculate the amount of energy the kilowatt hour meter supplies when the disc in it makes 1 revolution. Switch on the kettle for 1 minute and count the number of revolutions the disc in the kilowatt hour meter has rotated. You can then use the data to calculate the power of the electric kettle.Compare the power calculated with the power rating marked on the kettle. Are they the same? In this experiment, we'll use a kilowatt-hour meter to measure the electrical energy supplied to an electric kettle. First, connect the kettle to the kilowatt-hour.
Okay, so we can use the meter, kilowatt-hour meter, to measure the total energy consumed. Okay, now I'm look at this checkpoint 2. A true false question. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 100 joule. Of course, wrong. Should be 3.6 megajoule. Part B. In the bills, 1 unit means that 1 kilowatt hour. Okay. Part C. The cost of running a high power appliance must be higher than that of running a low power appliance. No. This one tells us that depends on the time. Okay? Because multiply them the power and also the time, it means that the kilowatt hour. High power, it means that kilowatt should be high. But how about the time? Hour. If you use it next time, then the cost should be less than the other one. Question number 2. Here. Equal to 12 kilowatt hour. Of course, you should do the calculation, but pay attention. In examination, usually mix up the value using the English. 2, can you see it? 2. 2, this. 1.5 kilo. So, actually, this one is very easy. You just do it 2. 1.5 kilowatts. And then ask you how many hours? 4 hours. Hour. 4 hours. Multiply them together. Then that's all. Okay? This one is the most easier way to do it. How many kilowatt hour? You should do it like this. Part B, similarly. 100 watts. Okay? 100 watt means that should be kilowatts. But only 100 watts. It means that 0.1. Pay attention on the English. Do you have any other number? No. And then 5 full day. 5 day. 5 day. But focus on it. We should know the hour. 5 day. 1 day should be 24 hours. Then multiply them together. Will be kilowatt hour. This. Can you see it? Part C. Here, 2 kilowatts, kilowatts, 2. And then switch on for 16 minutes. 16 minutes, it means that how many hour? 1 hour. So, how many kilowatt hour? 2 kilowatt hour. Part D. Similarly, 800 watts. Kilowatts, 800 watt means that 0.8. Operate 50, half hour. Operate 30, half hour. Half, okay? Hour. So, the answer should be like this. Okay? Part C. How long would it take for this fan to consume this? Okay, so go back to here. What? How many kilowatts for 50? Should be 0. This. If this one is 5, it means that 500. No, here now don't say 50. This one, kilowatts. Okay, and here we have hour, but how many hour? I don't know. Should be unknown T. Then combine them together should be kilowatt hour. But now this question wants you to know that how long for it to reach 1 kilowatt hour. It means that both of them have the same unit, but this one only 1. Then ask you what's the time T to make it 1. Should be 20. 20 hours. Okay, you understand? Question number 4. Here, this one. For the mains, operating voltage should be this, and then the mains will provide this main current, 12. And then for it operate in one day, should be only have 8 hours. What's the cost of running it per month? This. The cost should be this. Okay, what should you do? You should try to calculate how many kilowatt hour here. Okay? But how to know that the power? In this question, without any power, I don't know. But go back to here. An air conditioner operates in this. Just only give you V and I. But combine them together, you can get power. So you can find out the power first. We have the power, it means that how many kilowatt hour, and then you can calculate the total hours, then that's all. So calculation should be this. For the total energy, should be the power times time t. What's the power? Should be V and I. Pay attention to make it kilowatt hour. So you should divide by 1000. And then here, for one day, 8 hours. For 1 month, 30 days. Totally should be this. And for each 1 kilowatt hour, you should pay $0.9. After calculation, this one will be the total amount. That's all.